but I'm stuck on my brand. I'm stuck about my logo design. I'm stuck about exactly how perfect things are and how buttoned up and professional looks. Just get it done. Get it out there. Get your message out. Refine you. Define you in doing it.
Never short stopping. Now I'm winning like I'm Jada. Steady through the rigor. Yeah, I'm getting bigger. In them trenches, now I'm making seven figures like.
So imagine your friends, they say, hey man, we're going down the street, we're making a Pequod's run. They're doing a what? We're doing a Pequod's run. See, the three original owners of Starbucks actually were going to originally name their coffee shop Pequod's. So I'm here at the original first ever location of Starbucks, which is originally called Starbucks Coffee, Tea, and Spice, right here in Seattle, right here down the street from the Pike's Place Public Market. And here at the original Starbucks, first ever location for Starbucks Coffee, Tea, and Spice. And a couple of fun facts about Starbucks. Did you know that Starbucks logo has only changed several times? First original, obviously, logo was 1971. And then the next logo change was in 1987, then in 1992, and then in 2011. By the way, look at that line back there for everybody looking to get into Starbucks here during the pandemic, getting their cup of Starbucks. Cool thing too about Starbucks, that in Manhattan, of the 124 stores in Manhattan, over 68 Starbucks are within two blocks of one another. Talk about a Starbucks in every corner, huh? And then when Howard Schultz had the opportunity to do so, he purchased Starbucks from the three original owners for $3.8 million. So why do I say all this? Last night, we were doing a mentoring session here with some of the guys who were helping build an office here in the Tacoma, Washington area. Question came up, says, hey Matt, what do you think about branding? So before I really get my business started, how do I really start off my brand? And so the question really came from the position of, listen, Matt, I can't really get my business started because I don't know yet what my brand is. And the biggest frustration, I think, or the biggest area of procrastination, I think, with many entrepreneurs or those who want to become a first generation cash flow millionaire is they get hung up on things that really don't matter at the particular time of their business. For example, does branding matter? Of course. Does your personal brand matter? Of course. Does your logo creation matter? Of course. But when you're originally starting your business, you say, you know what, I can't start it unless I got the right logo, the right coloring, the right website, the right social media, the right handle. And here's what I discovered. You got to come up with a great product and service that people want to buy first. You got to come up with a great experience for a customer who want to talk about you first. You want to talk about what you do for other people to make their lives better, a problem that you're solving, and a solution that you're creating, so everybody starts telling them about you first. And it's not about the color of your logo. It's not the fancy logo design. It's not going to these fancy graphic designers and spending $300-$500 with a perfect logo design for you to actually start your business. If you want to become a first generation cash flow millionaire, you want to become an entrepreneur, you want to start a business, talk about what you are doing for the marketplace first, then your logo. I remember spending about $25,000. One of my biggest mistakes in my career was spending $25,000 on website, on templates for my letterhead envelopes, for logo design, for all those different things, without really understanding that I need to come up with a product or service that everybody loved, that everybody was talking about, that I was changing people's lives in the process. That wasn't part of the equation. So if you're out there saying, you know what, I want to create a great brand, create a great product, create a great service. It's not about the logo. It's not about the website. It's about how fancy you sound on the radio. It's not how fancy your or professional your YouTube videos are. It's not how fancy your videos are. Man, so many people get so much away with just straight up IG lives and Facebook lives without professionally producing it with a videographer and a video editor, without creating branding, intros, outros, bumpers, none of that stuff. None of the stuff was really created even on my YouTube channel until about 2-3 years into starting the YouTube channel, because I was wondering what my marketplace was going to tell me, what they wanted to hear from me, from the experiences I was creating. And through my 22 years of being an entrepreneur, you know what I've discovered? I discovered 3, 4, 5 different shifts in my brand, my business, that if I spent all this money in the beginning up front for logo design and ideation and professional videographer, professional video editing and website development, without understanding what my morals and values and principles were all about, what my product and service was all about, I would have wasted a lot of money, and worse, I would have wasted a lot of time, and nobody was going to talk about this. And today, because I didn't buy into investing into too much branding, sure, brand is important in the beginning, but you know what the most important thing is? Getting people to start talking about you. And now we've built a business from coast to coast, and people are starting to talk about us. Listen, I was walking in Dallas Love Airport, and I was just walking there with my son, because I took my son on a business trip with me so he can see what daddy does when he gets on airplanes, when he travels across the country. And The young lady said, excuse me, are you money smart guy? Are you seven figure squad? I said, yes, I am. Because I didn't realize you were this tall. And anyway, I just want to let you know how much you've changed my life, how your videos have improved the way I think about money, how I feel about money, how my perceptions about money, because how I was raised was completely different for how I see money now. See, that's the type of stuff that now I'm starting to invest in branding, in logo, and professional design. Get your message out there. Get your product out there. Get your service out there. Then the branding, in my opinion, comes secondary, third. Without having a great product or service or experience first, having a brand, it's just a waste of time and sadly a waste of money. Give that a shot. Let me know what your thoughts are. Drop your thoughts, your feedbacks in the comment section below. If you're finding somebody out there starting their business and you find somebody out there that says, man, I want to become a first generation cash flow millionaire, but I'm stuck on my brand. I'm stuck about my logo design. I'm stuck about exactly how perfect things are and how buttoned up and professional it looks. Just get it done, get it out there, get your message out. Refine you, define you in doing it. Not going back and forth in focus groups. With that being said, guys, if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe, hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. That being said, guys, I'm your Money Smart Guy, and until then again, from the Pike Place Public Market, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.